Getting a full history, really trying to understand what's going on, and a full description of the behavior is critical. Then one thing we try to do as we're assessing the problem, and this can take a while, is to do what's called ABC charting. This requires a bit of effort on behalf of the staff, let's say in a nursing home, but basically by ABC we mean A is for the antecedent, which means what happened before the behavior started. The B is for the behavior itself, and we need a clear description of the behavioral change. And the C is the consequences, so what happened after the behavior happened? How did everyone around react or respond? And so we get these charts for a period of time, and we start to see usually a pattern of when these behaviors are happening. What are the triggers for the behavior? So the most common thing, for example, would be Mr. Smith is perfectly fine most of the day, except during personal care, except when the staff have to help to bathe him or dress him, then he gets upset and agitated. And it could be that he doesn't understand what's going on, or he feels like people are doing things to him in a way that he doesn't want, or maybe he's afraid. So that can help us a lot then to figure out what the best approach is. And as we always state and keep stating, the optimal approach is non-pharmacological. We hope that we can intervene using a variety of approaches that don't require medications, and often we can. So this is really critical, and all of the guidelines for practice emphasize that the first thing we need to do is a really good and thorough assessment to try and figure out what's going on. And as I said before, there are different potential causes for behavior change. I mentioned the physical ones, but there are also environmental changes. So what's going on the unit? You know, is there, are other people on the unit upset or agitated? Maybe the staff are under extra stress and they're feeling rushed or burdened in some way. That can be felt by the residents on the unit. Maybe it's just a problem between two individuals. Maybe the person's roommate, for example, if they have a roommate, is doing something that's bothering them. Well, we sure need to understand that. Or it could be that there's a family issue. Maybe the person's family is under some kind of stress, and maybe they're not able to visit as frequently, and that's causing them to be upset. So it's complex to try and really figure out, you know, what's going on. So we start with a great assessment, really try to figure out what's going on, and then we consider what the best types of interventions might be.